Hey guys, Pasty Boy here. Today me and my brother Mark are gonna take a look at my 2000 Caravan trailer here. Needs a little maintenance, so let's get started. What's up, bro?
Morning.
It's my brother Mark, or affectionately known as Zook. So, what's that?
Gonna have some fun.
Oh yeah. All right, so it's kinda dirty. I don't even want to show you the front because it sits under that tree year-round unless we're riding. But up here in the front, Mark, what did you say happened here? Didn't one of these tie downs have to be maintained?
I got the, see the plate? It's under the sled.
Okay.
You gotta put a new plate in.
So it's on your, on that side, passenger side?
I got the plate. It fell off last year when we went out and bought that 12 600.
Oh, shag's backup sled. Yeah,
we went to tie it in, and the thing freaking fell right out.
Okay.
So I don't know if it rotted out the wood where it screws in. I think that's what happened, and then it just fell down. So,
all right,
put the new one in.
Take care of that. Looks like the whatever you call that. It's not really a shock or whatever.
Shock,
for the whatever you want to call that mandor kind of thing, that rusted out finally. So that's toast. That won't be able to be fixed today because I'll have to order something for that. And then these arms, for some reason,
they move around.
Yeah, they're a little sloppy. So we noticed last time we needed to get into it that when we went to lift the clamshell here, it didn't want to open because like these things were
shifts.
Yeah, I don't know. They kicked out or in or whichever way it needs to go to stop this thing from wanting to open up. So it was a little trouble.
These look loose.
Right. Let me show you what I just saw here. So there's like a gap here and that screw is really loose. So I don't know if that's
it. It could be it.
So we're going to start with that. It's just a flathead screw. We're going to tighten it down to wherever it gets tight, close the thing, and then see if that works. So I'm going to throw the camera on a tripod and we're gonna get started. Quick shot of the right side. It looks fully tight, so, and I'm almost positive it was that side that caused the problem.
Yeah.
So that might be a simple fix, tighten it up.
Shifting it over, and that's why it was locking up there.
So Mark's gonna try to tighten that up.
Oh, no.
No, it's stripped.
Oh, there's, it's two-headed. Oh, it's got a, one's a sleeve. That's why.
Ah, okay. Yep. You gotta hold that.
That's tightening.
Okay. So you don't want to tighten it too much because then it can't move.
That's that.
Right.
Well, let's see if it fixed the open-close problem.
See, outside is, or the inside, I'm not sure which, is like a hollow internal threaded screw. And so that screws into the other one apparently, right? Is that what you're seeing?
Yeah, so
you think
one of the sides is hollow. One's a screw, one's a hollow sleeve with threads in it. So either this threads into the other side or this threads into this side.
Yeah, that's what it seems like at least.
Yeah, it's got to be.
I don't know. Never seen anything like it.
No. All right, let's see what it does.
Yeah. All right. We got to pull these pins out. Now, really, I should be replacing these shocks or whatever, but that's why it came with these pins. All right. So close that.
It's hitting right there.
Where is it hitting?
This. How's that possible?
All right, let's see. Do that again. Yeah. That's weird. So that's definitely kicking out, it looks like. So it's the right side, wasn't even the left side. And as you can see, it doesn't want to open. Now we did get it open today.
Yeah.
Obviously. All right. There we go. A little wiggle. So we got to find out why this thing, it could be too loose down here possibly.
I don't know.
I mean, that's the only thing. If the pivot point is tight, then it's either too loose on the top or too loose on the bottom. And it worked fine for the first 5 years that I've owned this thing.
Right.
So, all right, we're going to do some tightening and see if that helps. All right, so here was the culprit. There was a ton of slop on this thing. We just had to tighten this bolt up because I was checking the play here and it was quite sloppy. Probably a good quarter inch there.
Yeah.
And when I looked on this side,
tighten that or no?
There was okay? There was none. No, I mean, that's good.
Close. Okay.
So, you know, that's good. And so, and now we just did the test, actually. I'll let Mark show you that it works. So,
hold that pin.
Pull the pin. All right, so we're going to drop it. And he's going to reopen it.
Totally fine.
And it works perfect again. So, Mark was kind of pushing up on the clamshell and wiggling it just to see what it was doing. And so I see these two bolts are sticking out here, but the hinge looks loose up front there. So, and it looks like it's either starting to wallow out. All right, so what we're gonna do now then, here, do give that wiggle, and I'll show what that's doing. So I'm gonna zoom in. Yeah, so right there, that hinge is not doing squat. So the first thing we're gonna do is remove this piece of particle board because we can't access the bolts, the carriage bolts that go through the side from outside because they're underneath this piece of particle board. So we're gonna remove that so we have full access and then go from there. All right, so we cut this carriage bolt out of there. We didn't remove that one yet, but we went and bought new hardware. And we've kind of got this propped up here to relieve the tension off of the hinge, which we removed from this side. I don't know if you can see. It was in that corner, just like the hinge that's right there. But obviously this isn't the type of hinge you're gonna be able to find at the corner store, so gonna have to look online. But for now, I think what we're gonna do is replace these two carriage bolts. And so we went and found a bunch of stuff at Home Depot here. So we're gonna use like these galvanized bolts and washers and things to replace that. So that's what we're gonna do now, right? Exactly. And we gotta find some hardware. Maybe we'll put that part in for the tie down. You can see that part right there used to go up from under the trailer and through in between those two bolts there. You see where the washers are for the tie down, and that stripped out. So we have one from the underside, a nice thick steel plate.
Find that right one, but
yeah, for now that's going to work with the tie down. We have to find something to prop that open with. I don't think I'm going to bother buying a new shock or whatever because that's probably going to cost like $30, and I don't really use that door much. We just need something to keep it propped open. Me personally, I actually have to get in the trailer to tie them down anyway because I'm so short that I can't even reach it from outside anyway. These guys can, and they do everything from outside.
I barely
can. Right?
I'm 5'9", I barely can do it.
I'm 5'1", I can't. And so we put new bolts. I know it doesn't look the greatest here, but we used stainless steel washers and...
at least it's sturdy now and it's correct.
And galvanized bolts because it's aluminum. And so steel and aluminum don't like to mix. We would either had to use stainless steel. We just decided to get galvanized for the bolts and nuts. And I'll see if you can see that from the inside up there. But the two, you can't really see the other one because it's, let's see here. There you go. And I put stainless steel washers and galvanized lock washers behind it. So now I have to find a hinge that's like that one there, so we can put it down in that corner. And like I said, something to prop that up. That'll be in the next part, not today, but it might be still part of this video. So we'll catch up. The clamshell is now opening and closing perfectly again. And once we get that hinge in, I think we're gonna be in solid shape here. And you can kind of see on the roof of the clamshell where I don't know, maybe you can't. There's some light leaks.
Oh, you know why?
So, yeah, it pulled through.
No, there was lights up there. Did you? If you look at the front, there was marker lights.
Okay, well, we got to seal those up so we don't get any drips.
Yeah, somebody had marker lights there and ended up taking them off.
That makes sense.
I noticed that.
Yeah. And you can see it on the side, too, which is just a little rivet pulling through here.
Caulk line? Look. There was marker
lights. No, but this is the front. We're talking the top.
Yeah, right there. That's what that is. You're looking at the wall, not the top.
No, I was looking at the top. Looking at the top.
Oh, up there. Yeah. They're just... I thought you were talking about those holes.
No. Anyway, it's minor. I mean, it's minor. That's nothing I'm really worried about.
So maybe my stuff little... didn't leak gas. That was water coming
out. Oh, yeah, sure.
It smelled like gas.
It's water. Water's gas water. All right. Anyway, guys, we'll be back when we got the hinge.
I'm getting some behind-the-scenes footage of Pasty Boy. The rare phenomenon. Him in the wild.
Yes, that's me. Hey, guys. All right. We're back here with my brother, Mark. We're going to continue on with the trailer repairs and maintenance and whatnot. It's a bit colder today. It's in the, low to mid 40s?
50s?
It's freaking freezing. Check your phone. What the hell is it? I'm cold.
Yeah.
And we weren't cold last Saturday.
Yeah.
But anyway, let me show you what I got and what we're going to do here today.
45.
I knew it. It's 45 out. Okay. So we've got, I got this piece of cabinet grade plywood, 15 and a quarter by 8 foot. It's gonna go over here. Let me see if I can show you that. Cause this was the particle board piece that was in there, probably like 3/8. That's gonna go right down in there to protect all that. And you'll be able to stop on it. That way you don't, go through. And then I got some other stuff here. So I got a new gas shock for the door because that rusted out. Believe it or not, this is a cheap Chinese one, but I got two for $20, including tax, free shipping on Amazon. I'll put a link in the description if you're interested in those, and then hopefully they last. And then we're going to attach them with these four tech screws. Then I got head order hinges because the one on that far corner is broken. So I got blanks so we could drill them exactly where they need to go, the holes, like the old one. And we're going to fasten this wood with all these tech screws. They're 1¼ inches. We already have the hardware to mount the hinge. We bought it last week. And then I just grabbed this caulk or whatever, silicone, so that we can seal up some of the holes and things, you know, on the clamshell. Are you ready?
No.
You cold?
Yes.
Exactly. All right. Well, let's... What should we do first? We'll install the little gas shock on the door?
No, we should make coffee first.
Okay.
No. All right, I'll tell Don to put on coffee and we'll start working.
All right, great. All right. I'll get the drills ready.
Okay.
All right, so first thing we got to do, drill out those two rivets, get that old broken, rusted out thing out of there.
Well, the first thing we had to do was put my Pasty Boy hat on because my bald head is freezing.
Yes, and I should have brought mine. My head's cold too. Might drive back home and get it. I don't know. But let me get the drill bit and we'll start drilling out those rivets.
There we go. When we were little, our dad had a truck cap and it had springs like this. Well, it came out, the spring popped out and hit Pasty Boy right here. He looked like a tiger.
All right, so we're gonna offset it a little bit because of the fact that the other holes are a little wallowed out. We're gonna start fresh, so I'm gonna put one right here. Is that holding loose?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if it's gonna get any tighter.
Well, put the other one in, then we'll worry about it.
Okay.
not getting tight.
This one did, but for some reason that one didn't. I'm gonna go inside the trailer and do the other one. Let's see. Go at the bottom first.
Yeah, don't smash my hand.
No, that's not.
Wow, why did that not have a cut?
I don't know.
That was odd.
We gotta tap it out a little bit to line it up. Just like that.
This,
oh, you know,
this shot obviously really, isn't great.
Yeah, I got really close to the sidewall, that's why. Oop, now it kicked out again. Oh, Jesus. Yeah. Okay. Let's see how it works.
Wow. Holy crap. It actually works. Of course it did. We might have to throop my or sugar.
Look, it's bending the hell out of it.
I know, because it's not in tight.
Look at that, how much.
Yeah, that's not good at all. Wow, those are so loose, but.
But it shouldn't have come out like
that. No. Yeah, it's stripping.
All right, so if you see at some point somebody through bolted the door here in order for it to hinge better, I don't doubt that's stock. So that's what we decided we're gonna do here.
So
hopefully this isn't too long. This is what Mark.
Yeah, if not, I got another shorter one.
Yeah, so we're gonna try that. We've got some lock washers, a regular washer. So we'll start.
I don't throw away all that stuff.
Yeah, I don't either. I keep everything. Keep too much.
Mm-hmm.
I'm throwing out stuff and then I take it back out of the garbage. Up. Oh, gotta go a little bigger.
All right.
There we go.
Okay.
We're in. Okay. I've got it mocked up here. Washer underneath. Lock washer in between as a spacer, but I have to put a washer on before that lock washer. So we're going to use this galvanized one. That's all we've got, which is okay. But actually, what am I doing? Yep, okay. And then we got to get the wrenches on there. So this is a little bit smaller. The one on top's not moving yet, so I'll wait till that moves. What size is this sucker?
Same thing.
That's a 10, so we're going to need a second 10.
If it spins. Very well may not. And once we tighten them, it should compress itself.
We really should put a freaking plate here.
Yeah.
If it starts giving us trouble, we will.
Yeah, we'll worry about it. We'll do the fix on the trailer, or on the trail.
Let me go on the inside. Oh yeah, trail maintenance. Remember
that's
that?
Right.
That's a video going well way back.
Trail maintenance.
You always do your maintenance on the trail.
That's what I blew the O2, right?
Oh yeah.
That was fun.
Of course.
All right,
give it a shot, see how it works.
Doesn't stay closed.
Too long.
Too long.
We gotta lower this inside one. Okay. And sadly, we may have to through bolt that too.
Yeah.
We'll try it again and we'll see. I'm gonna lower it. You wanna give me the impact? All right, since the aluminum is so thin and starting to where, as you can see, like even here, there's nothing through that, and there's a rust hole there. I had to through bolt this on both sides, and on the inside, I'll show you what we did here. I went and I bought an 1/8 inch piece of aluminum length, 3/4 by 1/8 inch, and then tech screwed them into the frame here, so now it's really strong where this was starting to it wasn't very strong anymore. And so now it is. We got it bolted in, and I'll show you how it closes. No problem. Yeah, we do have a couple bolts here, but they do clear, and a couple bolts up here. And then you open it up and it works just fine. It holds that perfect. It's not gonna fall on your head whatsoever. This shock is nice and strong. And since I only used one of the two, that's 10 bucks. Now, because we've got other plans today, we're gonna have to come back again tomorrow and continue with putting in the hinge and this piece of plywood. So we'll catch back up with you then. All right, guys, we're back. It's Sunday, another day later. A week and a day later than the very first part of this video, but anyway, show you what we're up to today. So here we have one of the blank hinges. I matched it up for this corner here, kind of made a mark, and then I matched it up to the actual other hinge that was there. This, the center part of this hinge is slightly bigger, but I don't think it's going to make that much of a difference. So we're going to put this side in. And last night when I started editing the first part of this video, which was yesterday's portion, I guess that's the middle part of this video anyway, but it'll all be one video. I noticed that that hinge is almost ready to break right off. I'll show you real quick. Yeah, right there. So zoom in. I noticed it while I was editing, so you can see two of the three, or whatever, most of it, so hanging on by a thread there, just in that one side. So we're gonna have to replace that one too, but the two center ones are just fine, so we're gonna leave those for now. There's probably very little stress on those center ones, that's why. Anyway, onward and upward. We're gonna put that hinge in next. All right, let's take a look at what we've done here today so far. All right, so we replaced this hinge down here. Brand new hinge, aluminum, but the bolts are galvanized. They're not as strong as I thought they'd be. Just thought they'd be strong, you know, stronger, but whatever. Because here we got the second one in, because I noticed it was cracked pretty badly, and one of them broke. So we got to go for a 73rd trip to Home Depot for hardware, and then we'll finish it up with that piece of wood. So see you when we get that. All right, guys, Pasty Boy here for the final episode of the trailer rehab or whatnot maintenance. So basically it's almost all done, and if you stick around to the end, there's gonna be a little additional info. So stick around. What's up, bro?
What up?
What do we, what's left to do here today?
One last bolt on the hinge and then the plywood along the front. I think
Yeah, we got an interior piece of plywood, which you've seen before in the other videos. We already put the new shock here for the door. Yeah, it's gonna go right there so that if you're in the trailer and you step there, you don't punch your foot through here.
It's very easy to do.
Got a new pin, and then if you remember, what was it, the year before last, we did the new lift assist from Caliber on the trailer because the original one failed. Let's get it open and get her done. Right?
Yep.
All right. So we have to put that final bolt in there because this one broke. So I got a new one. Get this out of the way, it's no good. And then once we get that in, bolt that up nice, put that piece of wood on here that I got, that 3/4 inch finished ply, and then I'm just gonna go through and caulk, you know, some of these little leaks. These are already caulked, so even though you can see light there, that's got clear silicone in it already. But here on the roof, it needs some silicone. So we'll do that. Last, we'll catch up when we make some progress here. Alrighty, we've got that buttoned up. That was the last bolt down there. So essentially we'll put that wood on next and start caulking, and we're done. All right,
So we're gonna tech down this plywood, this furniture grade plywood.
That's right.
Hey, there's good job. Long.
So these are pretty long. So marked it out so that I know I'm hitting one of the cross bars here. Just gotta get it started because they're long and you can't dilly-dally like I am. So I'm just gonna get started.
Easy enough.
Yeah.
Well, the aluminum's soft.
Well, not so bad there.
Yeah.
You know, it's pretty good.
No, I'm saying it goes through easy.
Oh, yeah. There goes one. He's got one for safekeeping in there. All right,
so it's back there in case he needs an extra.
Yes, 20 years from now. All right, I'm going to go here.
We're not telling him who he is yet.
Yeah. Let me back it off in case it wants to go down. Bam.
Alright.
Now I'll put two in the corner. Nope. That's right on the edge of the...
Yeah, so it's probably real thick.
No, I gotta go closer to the edge of the wood.
Okay. Alright.
These are self-tapping, so they are... cutting their way through the aluminum. See the tip? So, yeah.
Yeah, I'm getting some good shots here.
That's right. All right, a few more to put in and this part's done. All righty, plywood installed. For protection, you're in here for any reason, you step there, that ain't going anywhere. That there is 3/4 inch plywood. Put 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 tech screws in there. Fully penetrated the aluminum tubing. That's good for many years. Got the shock there, got our caulk gun. I bought some clear, like what this was, like special stuff or something.
Silicone adhesive.
Yeah. Well, it's okay, so let's take a look here. I think I might have shown it in the other one. So it's all-purpose silicone, excellent flexibility, freeze and sunproof, and strong adhesion, 7-year mold free, whatever. So 7 years from now, we'll worry about that. So we're gonna just caulk up some of these spots, but I think we're gonna stick a couple screws. I should have brought my rivet gun. Could have put a rivet in there instead, because that's what they normally use. But we're gonna tack that down a little better and then caulk. So we just put some screws, tech screws with washers on the outside there, and you can see the gaps are closed up quite a bit. We're just gonna caulk it off now with some silicone there that I showed you. And this thing should be completely weather tight and ready for snow. Yeah, so we'll get that done and then we'll wash it and wrap it up. Show you that once the caulking's all done. Because we're gonna check, there might be like a couple back here, maybe, I don't know. I'm gonna look it over and make sure we get them all. Okay, we also, put a couple tech screws on the outside too, because a couple of the rivets had pulled out on the side, and we even added some silicone on the inside just to seal up any spots. We had one back there, but now we're gonna go on the outside and see if there's any obvious holes or anything and finish her up. This trailer has the edge glides on it. I bought new tie down bars for it maybe 2 or 3 years ago. I think I bought one year and one the following year at the Big East show. And that has like those great cranks there because it's got a handle that has
basically
swivels.
I stole my drill. Where is it?
Yeah, I didn't steal nothing. Did on the roof of the trailer?
Okay.
New plywood.
Little brother?
Yes. Of course. I got to keep you guessing. See, it's like a mental exercise to keep you, you know, on you're getting old, bro.
I'm mental and I don't exercise.
Okay. Anyway, so ski guides here, I don't know, they're a little warpage, but they work like a charm. These track and pick, you know, catches here work great, but my brother's sled just gouged them like crazy last season. I don't remember them being like this. You can see even the wood getting a little chipped, but it's still gonna last. I mean, it is pressure treated. Now, technically, this trailer has the gas shocks in the back, and that should have been enough to hold it up, but I think they've seen better days and they're gassed out. So we have these pins that we put in there to hold it up, and we don't have any issues with it. So lift it up, put the pins in, and it holds itself in place just fine. Got two spares. Those were the tires that I had on it that were new when I bought it. And I bought two brand new tires for this in January of 2019 that are still brand new. And that's where the trailer is at this point. So the back is pretty dirty. I did register it already, but it's I didn't put the sticker on yet. And then, let me see that. Looks like we're gonna have to reattach this. I'm not even sure these are connected. Never really paid attention. But it's still gonna be better. It looks like they had three in the middle that they removed at some point. All right, so I went in on the inside and reattached this. We even put a little bit of silicone around the edge of that. The other one was fine. And I think, other than washing it, we're done.
Yeah.
This thing's ready to be used.
Yeah, I'll get the spray to spray on it.
Yeah, we're gonna spray her down with some cleaner. And I brought my little electric pressure washer that you might have seen in a previous video when I was washing the sled off at the end of last season. I'll put a little card up there. All right, so my brother Mark's got this big old jug of Super Clean. Dissolves, degreases, super easy, super fast. Tough task, cleaner, degreaser. So he's over there spraying it down already. And we're gonna power wash it, and then we're done. What are we gonna do with this thing? I don't know. So we're in the process of cleaning it here. You can see how dirty that is. It's pretty filthy. Good job, but my arms are still tired.
Uh-huh.
It's almost done. It's looking freaking mint. Actually, it came really clean. So, yeah. So let's recap everything we did to the trailer in these 4 days, which spread out, of course, across about 3 or 4 weeks. Put two new bolts down here. The ones on the other side were still fine, so didn't feel a need to replace them. We replaced this hinge here, ordered brand new hinges online. Then the two center hinges were fine, and then we replaced the hinge on the left side as well. We replaced the wood that was there with 3/4 inch plywood, put a new gas shock on it, added some reinforcement tech screws to the roof, and a few more on the side to close up any rivets that had pulled through. We sealed up all of the areas, tightened it all up. So I'm real confident this thing is not gonna leak this year. All right, guys, thanks for watching. This trailer's all ready to go. Man, looks good. It came out great. The pressure washer tidied it up real nice. So for that little piece of news at the end here, when we started this project of, you know, doing some maintenance to the trailer, I just wanted to make sure it was roadworthy this year and wasn't going to give me any trouble. And then, so this has probably been, Mark, what was it, 3-4 weeks? How long we've been working on this thing?
3 weeks.
3 weeks, and this is like the 4th day that we've worked on it. But I decided, and about don't know, what's today? Saturday? Today's Saturday, right?
Yep.
Saturday, October 31st. It's Halloween. And I decided, like, Wednesday, actually bought a brand new trailer. So, selling this to Shag. So that's the news there. And so I'll let you know as that comes closer. And one of you know already what it is because you were with me when I actually bought it, well, other than my wife. And Mark knows, and Shag knows, but and Gary knows. But you guys won't know because I want to show you when I make the video, when it comes in. It's, they said 2 to 4 weeks before it gets here. And but we'll give it a final look over here of Shag's new trailer. But it cleaned up nice. And you know, still gonna perform very well for this season. So any last words, Mark?
I'm hungry.
You're hungry? What time is it?
2 o'clock?
Yeah. All right. Yeah. That sun is killing the shot. Yeah. But anyway, all right. As always, guys, I wanna thank you for watching. If you like what you saw, please give the video a thumbs up. Please check the links in the description. If you need anything that I use or snowmobile related, even other stuff that you've seen on my channel, I have an Amazon affiliate page. The link is below. I will put a link to the gas shock that I put there. I'll also put a link to the Caliber gas shock for the lift assist for tilt trailers. And go like me on Facebook and Instagram. And we'll see you next time. Take care.